worried about your team missing the tournament, potentially?
Oh, we're talking about tournament already? We're talking about our next game at this point. You know, it wasn't a great effort. I will tell you that I thought Notre Dame played unbelievable, like 22 for 38 shooting and missed the cage only 7 times. And it was the first quarter like I haven't seen in a long, long time where they totally dominated. They couldn't make mistakes, and we were just, it looks like we were still on the plane somewhere trying to get here. So it was a rough one.
It seems like you guys have had games of very good defense, games of very good offense, but today was, I would say, probably neither. What's the key to being more consistent moving forward in terms of both sides of the ball?
It's a mental game, right? The game of lacrosse, like, if you're not super talented, you got to play like a team and really support each other and have great lacrosse IQ. And we showed in several games that we can do it at times, but today we didn't show up.
Against Duke, you guys were really playing physical and checking a lot of the attacks on Duke's side. And today, Notre Dame was able to find players just rotating the ball a lot, and specifically in the middle of you guys' defense. What issues do you think you had defensively, and how could those be improved?
You know, we just said, again, not physical enough. You know, it looked very different. They were very physical on us. They came out, pressured us. Put pressure. We were dropping balls. We couldn't even catch a throw in the first quarter, and you know they were making plays. You know, we miss a slide. They throw the ball to them. They get shots. They're going off the pipe and in, and it's just a tough day for us. Not our day today. So.
And do you think the travel issues had anything to do with that, or?
It's, you know what? It's never travel. It's always how well prepared you are mentally and physically, and today we just, you know, you're always going to have issues. It's how you respond. It's like playing a game. When you make a mistake, it's how you respond. You know, if you dig in your heels and say, that's not going to happen again, it's okay to make a mistake, learn from it, and move on. But when you make a mistake and you just mentally allow yourself to do the same thing again the next play, you end up in games like this.
Coach, you mentioned the shots being pretty close. What do you think Notre Dame did better on the offensive end, leading to more quality looks for them?
they you know, it was their, that first quarter was their quarter. They showed up ready to play, and they jumped on us, and they did not take the foot off the pedal. And that you know, and once they got a lead, you know, we played better, but we didn't take advantage of our opportunities. And unforced errors and forced errors were made it really tough to have any chance of coming back.
Coach, I spoke to Jake Taylor a few minutes ago. He was telling me how much he respected you, how much he looked up to you when I asked him about the behind-the-back goals. I guess, what did you see from him today, and did you guys expect that?
It looked like a career day for them, so certainly career day, and it was a great performance on their part. You know, that's what we wished our team, you know, could do and had done, and you know, they've had their struggles this year, but you know, they showed up, they played with confidence, they probably felt good about the game from, you know, just from the past two games last year, that if they played well, they could have success, and they did.
Last three matchups now with Notre Dame have all been one-sided. I know you can't speak about last year's matchups, but do you think it's some sort of matchup issue there, or did you guys just come out flat today?
You know, the game is so mental, and you know, we were battling, you know, the idea of what happened last year and how we're going to do something different this year. But when it happens and when you get a first quarter like that, it's easy to settle on what happened last year and realize that, you know, we don't match up well against them. But, you know, you got to show up every play and do something about it. You can't just, otherwise you revert back to, oh, well, this happened last year, they have our number. And that's kind of what went through, what happened today.
Last two for Coach.
Was it just an off day for the offense, or what was kind of going wrong specifically?
It was an off day for everybody. So you know, they kind of fed off each other. You know, we go come down that first quarter and we can't make a pass. We drop the ball. We get stripped. It was one bad play after another. And ball goes down the other end. Defensively, it's one missed slide, one missed check. And, you know, on their end, they're making every shot they take. You know, we're forcing bad shots at our end. They're scoring good quality shots down the other end.
And Coach, yeah, this is unrelated to this game, but I remember you telling me last year that when you took over the women's program, you asked every player if they were there to win a national championship.
Yeah.
I was wondering if you did the same when you first interviewed players for this men's team.
No, because this program has national championships, so the expectations there. When you're recruited to Syracuse, and we'll get back there again, and you know, we're gonna keep fighting and battling, and we're a little beat up right now, and we gotta take the players we have and do the best we can with what we have right now. And it's you know, unfortunately, when you're banged up, that's the way it goes. But you gotta play more like a team, and you gotta pull it together. And you know, like the weekend before, we proved we can do it. And now we got to show up and actually do it again.
Thank you.